The next speaker is Syed Nasir Hussain. It is your maiden speech, but
not maiden, sir.
Not maiden.
Maiden speech.
You have 5 minutes.
Sir, thank you for giving me this opportunity today. See, I had prepared so much that I would have needed at least 20-25 minutes to make all the points. Many speakers before me, including my own party man, have raised many issues and have spoken about many things which I wanted to raise. I would just like to restrict myself for 2-3 points, for which I think I have three, four minutes. It's actually good to see that the government is honoring the promise that was made to the people of Andhra Pradesh in the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act of 2014. It is also good to know that the present government is not only honoring the promise that was made by the previous government, but also at the same time, this government is thinking of expanding the higher education. Several points have been made by several speakers here, but specifically one from the BJP from Andhra Pradesh was speaking so much about the Modi government, the achievements of the Modi government in the last five years. I think I need to remind the people in the treasury benches. I would like to just give some data here, and especially to the friend who was speaking about the Modi government and its achievement in the past 5 years. As of 2017-18, 120,769 assistant professors and 45,148 temporary teacher positions have not been filled. So that over 2,07,000 teaching positions are vacant at all levels. This is the track record of the government. We can speak about the universities, we can start new universities, we can start new institutes of higher education, but if we don't have faculty positions filled, if we don't have new professors coming over, I don't think it will be sheer waste of money. And I think the government should, while starting new university, should concentrate on filling not only the positions, but also trying to attract some of the best brains from different parts of the world. We have our own people working in the different universities across the world. Probably the reason here is the kind of freedom and autonomy that is necessary for a university functioning probably is not there. That is the reason why some of our best brains are still teaching abroad. Someone was speaking here about attracting students from abroad, and this was also mentioned in the budget speech. I'd like to mention it here. Abhi mujhe lagta hai ki Maharashtra se apne sadasya baat kar rahe the. So I think it is very important to note, if you need to attract students from other parts of the world, if you need to attract foreign students, if you think students studying in India have gone and done very well, especially was mentioning about Nepal and other countries where they are heading the governments, they should also understand, if you need to attract the students from different parts of the world, we should try and give an atmosphere where there is no fear, where the students can come in your country, where there is law and order, where there is no social problems, where there is no mob lynchings, where there is no lack of peace and order in the country. Only then, I think the students from different parts of the country, different parts of the world will be attracted to India. There are many speakers who gave many so much of data of how there are no professors. But I would just like to mention here that 12 of the 40 central universities, 75% of the professors' positions are vacant, 75%. And in two universities, one central university of Haryana and the other central university of Odisha, 100% professor position is vacant in these two universities. If you look at the If you look at the declining rate of filling the faculty positions, in 2013-14, for professors, there were 1,25,338 professors who were working. From there to 2017-18, it has come down to 1,14,117. That means about 14,000 professors' vacancies have not been filled up, or the professors have come down. If you look at the figures for associate professor, from 2013-14, it was 1,82,681 professors who were working.
Your time is up.
In 2017-18, it was 1,39,000. So there's so much of data which says that in the past 5-6 years, not enough attention has been given to the higher education. No faculty positions have been filled. Rules have been violated. There's so much of interference of the government in the universities, especially the central universities. They're trying to monitor how a university thinks. They're trying to coach a university as to what the university has to do. I think what is needed now is not the establishment of new universities. What is needed now is that we preserve the autonomy and independence of our universities. Only when we preserve the autonomy, there can be more creativity.
Thank you.
More creativity will only help the nation to grow. There are so many other things.
I would end by
informing the house that there was one important news today. It was a good news. There's one Ramjal Meena, a security guard at JNU, a first generation learner, has passed the entrance examination for admission to BA Russian.
Thank you. The next
he was speaker. Supported by the students and teachers of JNU. I think that is
thank
how
you.
A university should be.
By the next speaker
I support the bill.
Sri
and take
Raja
thank you so much.